Alrighty, well, morning everybody, and back on again in time for some Gems of War. And, well, yeah, to start with, it's been a great work week. Just, everything just going off without a hitch, although not without injury. I mean, Thursday and Friday, again, great nights at work, but, coming home with my lower back just all kinds of fucked up, so. Yeah, and then, something else during the work week. I've been doing my Gems of War sessions in the morning, right when I get home. So instead of during the afternoon and evening, so because of this, there's gonna be a chance that my stream schedule is gonna change. I don't know, but I would like to, with the way I'm doing, the way I did things this week, I'd kind of like to keep it that way. Again, doing my gem sessions during the mornings when I get home from work. One big reason why is just to get it out of the way. And that way, so when I wake up later, around 2:30 p.m., I could just get up, do other stuff for like a few hours, and then actually lay back down. You know, then I'm waking up again around, I think it's like around 8:30 p.m. So I have this larger chunk of time to actually sleep. It was kind of the way I used to do it, where I'd actually be up most of the morning, and then lay down later on in the morning, and then wake up until like sometime later in the evening. I don't know if I'd ever return to that, but the way it's going right now, I like it. Again, doing my session in the morning, and that way, so I have more time in the evening to sleep. But right now, though, it's just talk. Oh, I screw. Right now, it's just talk, but it's just something I got going on right now. Yeah. In fact, I have been playing with it in PvP. Not always successful, but it's, yeah, I also did a couple class trials, which, now that you brought that up, for today's session, yeah, it's dailies, class trial, and then going into PvP, and, our guild is all done with the Tower of Doom, so we're at max rewards on that, so, yeah. And then, brand new album, I think it was like yesterday or the day before. It was, it's technically black metal, but it goes all over the place. Like, it'll do like medieval ambient music, dungeon synth. I think there's some acoustic folk music in here as well, and as well as black metal. So it's got a little bit of everything. But something. I thought I'd been at 30 by now. Instead, I'm at 26. But the only reason I can think of is it's now going one, two, three, four, five. Whereas without buying the battle pass, it just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. So it just, yeah, I thought you were supposed to get 10 levels per day. Thank you. hopefully tomorrow I'll have been promoted to the number 2 slot. Yeah, because I think you need, whoa, what was it? Like 3 mil? And I think it was like 1,200. Like 1,200 trophies. I'm already at double that. But yeah, screw. In case you had just now gotten here, it was a fucking great work week. I mean, despite the lower back being tore up, probably so much so that I was doing my gyms at work. I was doing my sessions right when I got home from work, rather than waiting till the afternoon to do them. So I think what might be happening in the future is I might actually be doing the streams in the morning rather than like 1 a.m. Later on sometime in the morning, I don't know. But I think it also means that I'm much less likely to actually stream during my work week. Cause normally I was doing it in the afternoon, but during that afternoon, I'm probably more likely to be asleep now. Oh, and I did forget to mention too, I'm back on 10 to 7. 10 p.m. to 7 a.m. for my shift. It's gonna be about that time. Just 3. Oh. Controller double tapped. Once again, controller double tapped. Level. hitting all the traps. Yeah, for this, just pick this one on a whim. Brown and green. Normally, something like this, I actually would have went with the Great King, but... And he's getting me in both battles, so he's just kind of a pain in the ass. So, I gotta be able to target him. I guess another way of looking at him. I gotta be able to take care of him personally. Yeah, now that I think about it, this album kind of reminds me of another op. Wait, let me turn it down. It kind of reminds me of another album I got. The World's Most Seafaring Drug Addict. The RNG on this media player seldom plays it, but yeah, it kind of does that. It'll roll from like medieval ambient music, then into what you're hearing now, metal, and then going back into medieval ambient, and then metal, then going back and forth. It seems this album does it too. Now he's up towards the top now. Not to mention that, yeah, they inflict a lot of, status effects. And curse. Of course, I'm gonna do that to myself too. Left a couple. Thank you. Missed it. Red four match. Match. Last trial. Mode. But yeah, I do a lesser version of this team in PvP for a purple. It's not a 100% foolproof, or there's a better word for it. I can't remember what it was, but yeah, I use the Doom Skype. Turns yellow into Doom Skulls. But yeah, this is it's stronger in PvP because in the purple part, because your opponents are also purple, so then blow into Doom Skulls. Terror can kind of help. In fact, it... comes in handy at the start. Extra armor helps. Starts a ball storm. I was doing that, but the problem is the more enemies you defeat, the less effective it becomes. When there's only like one or two enemies left, it's like I basically can't use it. That's gonna result in a 4 or 5 match somewhere. No. Oh shit, I forgot about that. Oh, okay. Yeah, I thought I read something about that in there. I probably only did it to like the first enemy, not all of them. And yeah, I wanted to have a belt. Wouldn't interact well with this. she's still up. And still up. Enough. Nope.
Uh-oh, retard alert!
I forgot he summons.
Thank you.
gotta be able to stop them both. Didn't help. Yeah, I'm getting a lot of this too. Random troop. Oh, I know what happened here. There we go. The only thing I can think of is, with all these brand spanking new troops that the game devs made, they forgot to add them to this screen here. And, I'm guessing random troop was probably something they entered into this game, like, as kind of a fallback, kind of a backup. Maybe like a placeholder screen or something. I don't think Night Reaver even has a whatchamacallit. Yeah. It's basically a thief class with some variations. Purple. hell was that? That's a... Never heard that voiceover before. No. The other issue. Weapon backfiring just like Wanda Stars. Fucking time. Hey, Cabela, stop them both. We'll be right back. Purps and yellows. How about him? Not too many skulls. Excuse me. Really bad voiceover. Try a lot. start. Hurry up. Right, just to get an entangle on him. Didn't last long. For Joe.
Yeah.
charge. Three matches. Oh, lucky. Okay, on to the next one. I was just here. Oh, shit, we gotta... Media issues, I gotta restart it. Well, there you go. Matches. Just to get the submerge off of her. Done here? No. Score match. Keeping the hands away from the keyboard because they're kind of happy right now. Enough. Search! Fuck it. I want to make sure I'm picking matches all morning. Turned to shit quick. I feel like going back to war gear, and I am no fan of this one either. That's gonna do me. Not at all. Just keep it at elementalist. Maybe? Just gonna go ahead and do it. I'm willing to get a light storm going. Surprise, surprise. Thanks for telling me. Scorpius the monster? Yeah.
My blade is ready.
I think I tried, I tried out this team yesterday. Albeit, real briefly. Yeah, no rock solid on this class. Nobody poisoned on the bottom. Oh, it was poison. Yeah, yellow and purple. Thank you. surges. Yeah, I gotta go ahead and break off for a few. I gotta use the bathroom and refill this, and I'll probably make me something to eat while I'm up. So, anyway, I'll be back. Thank you. here. Either way. Do it again. I should know this. Okay. I can rip my skulls. Single one of them. Twice. Mirrors out kind of loud. Like I'm hosting. Get the surge. Never mind. Bob Match over there. Excuse me. It up, forgot to change the glass.
Uh-oh, retard alert.
Try this on your size. Oh, not this team. It's quick. Never mind. Got the life stone going first. Matches. You're welcome. Leaf storm with no leaves. Thank you, Jay. Yeah, good seeing you. Yeah, and, I've been saying this throughout the stream, but, this week was a great work week, so much so that I was actually doing these, sessions, in the morning, like, right when I get home from work, rather than, like, in the afternoon, after I've, taken a nap. So, which, actually works pretty well, because in the afternoon, I can just lay down for, like, one good solid chunk of time. And now, like, take a nap, wake up, do my jump to war session, and then try to get a mere pittance of a nap afterwards. Nothing official right now, but there's a chance that I might actually like on my nights off, start doing streams like later in the morning, like in the morning hours, like around 7-8 a.m. or something. Plus, I'm back on 10 to 7, 10 p.m. to 7 a.m. my work week. Quick. Just on a whim. Yeah. Yeah, now I'm pretty much burnt on vinyl, crazy as that might sound. And secondly, the thrift store where I got a good chunk of my records is no longer there. It got replaced by a damn stormwater pond. So, now I got moved up like 4 or 5 miles up the road, so less worth my while to go up there. And then there's the, I'm wanting to export my stream videos to YouTube now, so that pretty much killed any chance of me playing any vinyl, because nearly all my vinyl is copyrighted, so. Oh. damage. Okay, I'm screenshotting this. Never mind. I missed something else. Fucked it up. Cutting and trimming right now. I'm wanting to do this now, because I'll most likely forget later. And then here, just totally on a whim. I definitely ain't winning, but I'm actually lasting a while.
That's it, man. Game over, man. Game over.
gonna leave that as my, or at least for right now, I'm gonna leave that as my defense team, a bunch of peasants. Surprisingly, it actually lasted a while. Well, I guess we're back in Orkville. Surprise me. There we go, finally. Go for it. I'm getting down here too. That went. Damn. So it's not like some of the car ads I've seen over the years, like where the whole front end is like totally demolished, like it went high speed straight into a wall, and the description's like front end, swipe front end damage, easy fix. Congrats on the car, dude. And it's a 94 too. I think that's right around the time those Mustangs first came out. I remember because back around the 90s, I had a job detailing cars at a Ford dealership out in I think it was out in Chicago. We lived out in Grays Lake, Illinois, but I drove down to Chicago for the Ford dealership. So you really babied it, huh? I don't remember where I heard it or read it, but I got something about you can tell how well somebody takes care of their car by what the underside looks like. But like I said, I don't remember the exact wording on it though. Thank you. not enough. Bit of an epiphany, huh? Yeah. Yeah, because I'm sure all of his classmates are getting cars and stuff, and they're driving around, so I'm sure he wants to get one too. Yeah, you don't have to get a Lamborghini or anything like that for your kid. I mean, it's a simple driver's ed car could work. Basically, as long as it gets you to where you want to go. Stinking hit point. You're either with us or against us. Looks like I'm gonna have to deal with red and yellow. I've got that problem too. I'm an old man and I'm gonna be 52 at the end of next month. My car is like about 15 years old, yet the insurance is going up, not going down. I basically had to take my car off of full coverage in order to make it affordable. It's basically just straight liability now. But yeah, I don't get that. Maybe the guy who wrote your insurance hates Mustangs. I gotta get out of the skull store before I get killed. Don't surprise me. Well, that's what I got. Chevy Cobalt. It's a driver's ed car. Might be long-winded and may not make any sense, but I see that in video games, in some video games too, like MMOs and stuff. You know, players constantly complaining about a certain mechanic or a certain underpowered character or something. Oh, how could I put it? You know, and then the devs decide to rectify the problem by giving, you know, make or redoing a mechanic, but redoing it in such a way that it actually makes it worse rather than makes it better. Or, you know, the monk's super punch ability has a 3-minute cooldown. I'm hardly going to use it, you know, all these players are saying. So the game devs decided to go ahead and knock the cooldown down to 2 minutes and 55 seconds. They'll add the super punch now does plus 20% damage. You know, like they're kind of being stingy at the negotiating table. I kind of see that here too. Because I think what's going to happen, I mean, you know, they don't want the market to collapse because then they're pretty well fucked. But they'll probably roll out some stupid incentive program, or they'll, you know, like rebates, maybe like being able to report it on your taxes or something, you know, tax deductible, just little small things, just anything but actually fixing the damn problem. And sorry if this part doesn't make any sense, but in Dungeons & Dragons, the monk class is, I guess, is considered one of the worst classes in that entire game. Mechanically, it just sucks. But with the with this current 5th edition, I don't think it's 6th edition, maybe a 5.5 edition or something like that, but they try to address it, like, you know, monks have key points, basically works kind of like mana, kind of like spell slots. Like, you can only, I think it's like 1 point per level or something like that. But a lot of people were complaining about, by the time they're even able to rest, or they're even able to, you know, recover those key points, they're already gone through like water. So what Wizards of the Coast went ahead and did is, okay, you can refresh, you know, they gave you this mechanic where you can refresh your key points, but only once per day. That's a little help. I mean, once per day? No, you fix the damn problem from the ground up. I mean, so, like I said, sorry if this is kind of probably going way off the trail here, but again, I'm kind of seeing this in the collapsing market too. Yeah. You know, maybe in younger days when we were kids and, you know, teenagers, and we wanted to show up and, you know, show off how badass we are, but we're old men now. So time to put away childish things. And then, because the voiceover on this team I'm about to use is so annoying, alright. This is gonna be a bit on the loud side. Yeah, but I'm trying to cover up this guy's voiceover. I can't remember what the original voiceover was, but it wasn't nearly as obnoxious as this one. Damn it.
God fucking damn it!
Disregard that. I got a finger happy. In fact, I need to check that. Okay. If you want my whole console history, back in the 70s, I had an Atari 2600. In the apartment complex I was living at the time, back in the 70s, one of my neighbors had an Intellivision, went over and played that. One of my other neighbors, he had a Texas Instruments home computer, went over there and played that. I don't think, and then my dad sold the 2600, and I think the kids around that time were sick and tired of me coming over to visit them. I'd worn out my welcome with them, so I didn't play any consoles until probably the 90s. I think I was living with my mom. One of my neighbors had a Sega Genesis. Went over and played his. Until I wore out my welcome with him. So, didn't play any consoles for a while. Some point in the 2000s, when I finally got my own apartment, it was a PlayStation, Nintendo 64. I think there was something else, I can't remember what. But eventually, I got myself a PS2. I think I still had my Nintendo 64. I want to say there was another... Oh, I guess it was just those two. But yeah, eventually, right around the, probably the late 2000s, or about the mid-2000s, I just switched over to PC only. I'd say roughly 10 years ago, I had a PS4. That's when I first started streaming. That's what I was using. But yeah, it sucks ass, so Eventually, I just went to just PC only. Got a long storied history. Castlevania, Symphony of the Night. So, yeah, quick and easy answer on that one. Otherwise, aside from that, Final Fantasy Tactics is definitely one. Oh, you said PS2. Metal Gear Solid, Sons of Liberty, first comes to mind. Dynasty Warriors 3, but even then, I'm not a huge fan of the games themselves. I just grabbed it because it's based on my all-time favorite book, Romance of the Three Kingdoms. Final Fantasy 12, or whichever Final Fantasy had the Gambit system. I think Balthier was on it. I also want to say it's the first game where the Viera introduced, you know, the girls with the bunny ears. Happens again at the bail. Let's see how many gems there were. Sixteen. I don't think he... Yeah, upper left. I'm looking at that. 16 green gems on the board. Doesn't give me a poor match, I might just bail. Or does it do the damn Drifting Sands one? But yeah, I think most of my favorite games were on the PlayStation. Back to Goblin again. Jump burnt to a crisp on them, so looks like Drifting Sands it is. Oh, in case you're wondering what I'm talking about, I'm doing PvP right now, and each one of these kingdoms has a specific requirement. Like in this case here, you can only use troops that are from the Drifting Sands Kingdom. And like here, you can only use Goblin troops. You can only use Orc. Here, like, all of your troops have to have blue as one of their colors somewhere. So on and so forth. I mean, Yeah, and I'm pretty sure the load times on that are a hell of a lot faster than some of the games that I played on PC over the years. City Skylines is definitely a game that comes to mind. That was, used to play it a lot until I just ended up saying, ended up calling it quits on it because, one, it takes longer to get started on my game than it does to start up my whole computer. It also takes longer to shut down that game than it does to shut down my entire computer. So, yeah, that's pretty bad. Yeah. On that. Something else before I forget. fucking matches.
God fucking damn it!
Of course, it also doesn't help at all that I'm up against a light storm. Also, the way it's looking, too, it's, oh, yeah, hang on here. Oh, excuse me. Yeah, I'm gonna be, shutting down fairly soon. Both, cell phone and tablet, I think they're probably at about 20-15% charge. Three matches. Three matches. What? Oh, wow. Oh, damn. I didn't think they were that expensive. Now that I think about it, I think even Rollins was complaining about that. Like, people would come up wanting his autograph, wanting to sign a whole bunch of their stuff, but what they would end up doing is selling it all on eBay, trying to make money off of it. Chances are that might have been what happened there. Yep, beat me to it. That's probably what they're doing. And like I said a few moments ago, chances are they're probably autographed. I figured his books would be cheap. I mean, not many people give a shit about him, so... I figured he'd be finding his stuff in the bargain bin. Was on that, huh? Damn. I know he's been in movies, but I figure those are like we're gonna be the more obscure ones. Did he play a big part, or was it just like a little itty bitty bit part? Oh, second season. Yeah, after this run here, I'll probably end up calling it a sesh. Thanks for dropping by, man. Yeah, good seeing you. Fuck that up. What all those free matches you got? You're welcome. Here, let's see if I can fuck myself some more. Sure did. Well, it got me bleeding from the asshole on that one. Oh, there went that.
May the Lord guide thee.
Okay. The dust storm was about to run out anyway. It's starting to feel like a pure faction battle right now. Just going for it. Let me do some cleaning up, and oh, call her good. Yeah. This guy came out of nowhere. For all I know, he was probably dead last. Alrighty, well, that's gonna do it for me, everybody. I'm gonna go ahead and call it good. Tablet's pretty much at zero. Cell phone's at about 10%, so I gotta get them on the charger. Plus, I still need to get going on my blog post. I didn't get around to putting down much stuff yesterday, because again, I was pretty much in there sleeping and napping and all that. So I'm basically doing double duty today. I got 2 days to do. Then still gotta get going on my stream video as well. Gotta get that all prepped up and then exported to YouTube and all that good stuff. So, but otherwise, hey, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that. And then tomorrow my default time is gonna be 1 a.m. But if I don't start until like later on in the morning, don't be surprised. It's like I said at the start of the stream, there's gonna be a chance that that might happen. But again, we'll cross the bridge when we come to it. So. And that is U.S. Central Time, too. So. But until then, thanks again for coming by, everybody, and I'll see you all next time.